Good morning students, today we are going to see chapter 4 algorithmic strategies. An algorithm is a strategy that always guarantees in the correct answer. Learning objectives, here the learning objectives are linear search and binary search. Linear search is a searching algorithm in which we sequentially check each and every element until we find the element. We are looking for the whole array, or we reach the lost element and the element is not present. Let we see the example for linear search in real life time. Suppose there are 30 students in library. In a library where obviously you can't shout and you want a child named Suresh, then the only way to find him, each and every child, and ask his name. And that is how you will find so-called Suresh. And this search is called linear search, and also it is possible that the children are sitting alphabetically. This is the example for linear search. Pseudocode for linear search. Just we are going to search key value for the whole array by using for loop. In each and every iteration, we compare the target value along with the current value of the list. Suppose if the value matches, it displays the current index and the value of the array. If the values does not match, it moves on the next array element. And finally, if no match is found, it displays the search element not found. Let us see the example for linear search. Index 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, values 10, 12, 20, 25, 30. In this array, we are going to search the number 25. Here linear search will go step by step in a sequential order. It's starting from the first element in the given array. If the search element is found, that index is returned. Otherwise, the search is continued till the lost index of the array. In this example, number 25 is found at the index number 3. So here the output is 3. Here the input values 5, 34, 65, 12, 77, 35. Here the target element is 77. So in the linear search method, we'll go the step by step in a sequential order, starting from the first element till the element is found. In this example, number 77 is found at index number 4. So the output is 4. Let us see the another example. Here the input values 101, 392, 1, 54, 32, 22, 90, 93. So by linear search method, we'll go step by step in a sequential order, starting from the first element in the array. So here the target value is 200. in this array, we could not able to find the target element. Here the element is not found, so the output value is -1. If the value is not found in the array, here the output is -1.
In your book, we are given index 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Values are values 10, 12, 20, 25, 30. So here, by using the linear search method, here the target value is 25 is the target value. By using linear search method, here first value is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So here first one we are going to check the value is 25 is equal to 10. If 25 which is equal to 10, here the index value is 0. So the output is 0. So here 25 is equal to 10, not equal to 10. And next one is 25 is equal to, here the target value is 25. So first we are going to find this values. First we are going to find this values 10. Here 25 is not equal to 10. So here the value is not found. And next one is, next we are going to compare this value. Here the first value is 12. 25 is equal to 12. So here also not equal. So here also element is not found. And next one is, next iteration which moves on second value, that is 25. So here the next one is 25 which is equal to 20. Here also not equal, which means value not found. So here this all the values are values not found. Here this all the values which we not found. And next one is moves on the next one. This is the third iteration. So here 25 which is equal to 25. Yes, here the condition is satisfied. Yes, 25 equal to 25. Here the condition is satisfied. We got the value 25. Here the output is value is found. Here the output is value is found. Like this we are going to using the linear search method. By finding a particular value or a particular element in a list or some sequence of elements. Input, values, what are the values which were given in the list? 5, 34, 65,
5, 34, 65,
12, 77, 35. Here this values are input. This values are all input values. So here the target value is 77. So in this values, here the target value is 77. Here target value is 77. So here the output is, what is the index value of the target value? Target value oda index value enavo adhu dhaan inga ulla output. Okay va? Let me find here the target value is 77.
By using the linear search method, here are the elements which are going to access one by one. That is, one element can be accessed by the another element.
So first, we are going to search. First element in the list is 5. So first, 77 is equal to 5. So here, these are the elements which is equal, not equal. So, and next one is third element. So here, 77 is equal to 3. So here also not equal. So the element is not found. And next one is 77, and it transfer the next element is 4. 77 is equal to 4. Here also not found. And next one is 6. So here the next element is 6. Here 77 is equal to 6. Here also not equal. And next one is 6 is transferred to the next element is 5. 77 is equal to 5. Here also not found. And next one is 5 is transferred to the next element 12. 77 is equal to 12. Not equal. Here also not value found. Here the 12 it transferred to the next element 77. Yes. Now we are going to check 77 is equal to 7. Yes, the condition is satisfied. Here the value is found. So what is the index value of 77? Index value of 5. I of 0 is equal to 5. I of 1, that is the index value of 1 is 34. Index value of 2 is 65. Index value of 3 is 12. Index value of 4 is 77. So here the index value of 77 is 4. So the output of this linear search is 4. So here the output is 4. Input, we see the another example. Input values,
values equal to 101392 154 32 22 90 93. So here we are going to search a target value is 200. Here first one is 200. Here 200 is the first value. So here 200 which is equal to 101, not equal. Then it moves on the next element 392. 200 which is equal to 392. Here also not found. 392 which is it's going to the next element is 1. 200 is equal to 1, which is also not equal to the target element. Here the next one is 54. So 1 would change to the 54. Here 200 which is equal to the 54. Here also not found. And next one is 54 is transferred to the 32. So here 200 which is equal to the element 32. No. So here also the element not found. And next one is 22. 32 will change into the 22. Here 200 which is equal to 22. So not found. And next one is 90. Here 200 which is equal to 90. So not found. And here the 90 which is transferred to the next element is 93. So and we could not able to find the target element. Here the output is minus 1.
Let us see the another example. Here the input values 101, 392, 1, 54, 32, 22, 90, 93. So by linear search method, we'll go step by step in a sequential order, starting from the first element in the array. So So here the target value is 200. In this array, we could not able to find the target element. Here the element is not found, so the output value is -1. If the value is not found in the array, here the output is -1. Binary search is also called half interval search algorithm. It searches a sorted array by repeatedly dividing the search interval in half. It begins with an interval covering of the whole array. If the value of the search key is less than the middle value, it narrows the interval. It's better than the lower half. Otherwise, it narrows up to the upper half. Here this process repeatedly going on. It checks until the value is found or the value is empty. Pseudocode for binary search. It starts with the middle element. If the search element which is equal to the middle element, that is middle value is equal to the number of elements in the array which is divided by the 2, it returns the index value of the middle element. If not, it compares the middle element with the search value. If the search value which is greater than middle index, we are going to select the right side elements in the array. Suppose if the search element which is less than the middle element, we are going to search the left side of the middle index and start with step 1. By searching the element, when a match is found, it displays the message the index of the element is matched. Suppose if no match is found for all the comparison, it displays the unsuccessful message the index of the element is not matched.
Let me see the example for binary search. Here the values are 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 99. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 99. Values. Here we are going to find the target values. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So what is the formula for finding the middle value of an element in the array? So our middle element kandupidikka formula na m is equal to low value plus m is equal to low value plus high value minus low value divided by 2. So which means, what is the lowest value in the array? 0. 0 plus, what is the highest value? 9. Minus, what is the lowest value is? 0. 9 minus 0 by 2. Which means 0 plus n by 2. So what is the value of n by 2? 4.5. So what is the value? 4. So here, the middle element is 50. Now we are going to find the element. Is 50 is equal to 60? 50 which is equal to 60? Not equal to. So 50 is not equal to 60. So now we want to change the middle element value to find the search element. So we are going to omit this part. So here the middle element which is greater than. So here the greater than values are given in the right here. The middle element value is 50. Now we want to change the middle element. So here the value is for.
So let me saw this values. Here the values is lowest value is 5 plus highest value is 9 minus 5 divided by 2. That is 5 plus 9 minus 5 means 9 minus 5, that is 4 divided by 2, that is 5 plus 2 is equal to 7. Here the 7th value is 80. 80 is the middle element value. Now we are going to compare the middle element value which is equal to the target element value. Is 60 which is equal to 80? 60 is not equal to 80. Now we are going to calculate this part. 60. 70, 80. So we omit this. So already we omit this. So now we are going to concentrate this three types of values. So here the lowest value is 5, 6, 7. So here the next we are going to concentrate 60, 70, 80. So in this values, here the middle element value is 80, that is 7. Here what is the greatest and lowest, what is the highest and lowest values? 60 and 70. So here what is the index value is 5, 6. So here 5 lowest value plus, here lowest value plus highest value is 6 minus 5 divided by 2. That is 5 plus 6 minus 5 is 1 by 2. That 10 plus 1 by 2, that is 11 by 2 is equal to 5. So here what is the index value of 5th element? That is 60. So here the target value is 60 which is equal to 60. Here the element is found. Here the searching value is found.
Linear search. Linear search is a searching algorithm in which we sequentially check each and every element until we find the element. Pseudocode for linear search. Just we are going to search key value for the whole array by using for loop. In each and every iteration, we compare the target value along with the current value of the list. Suppose if the value matches, it displays the current index and the value of the array. If the values does not match, it moves on the next array element. And finally, if no match is found, it displays the search element not found. Binary search. Binary search is also called half interval search algorithm. It searches a sorted array by repeatedly dividing the search interval in half. It begins with an interval covering of the whole array. If the value of the search key is less than the middle value, it narrows the interval narrow up to the upper half. Here this process repeatedly going on. It check until the value is found or the value is empty. Pseudocode for binary search. It start with the middle element. If the search element which is equal to the middle element, that is middle value is equal to the number of elements in the array which is divided by the 2, it returns the index value of the middle element. If not, it compare the middle element with the search value. If the search value which is greater than middle index, we are going to select the right side elements in the array. Suppose if the search element which is less than the middle element, we are going to search the left side of the middle index. and start with step 1. By searching the element, when a match is found, it displays the message, the index of the element is matched. Suppose, if no match is found for all the comparison, it displays the unsuccessful message, the index of the element is not matched. Here the bookmark machines are. What is searching? Write its types. Discuss about linear search algorithm. What is binary search? Discuss with an example. I hope you all understand the searching algorithms. In the next class, we will learn what is mean by sorting algorithms and what is mean by dynamic programming. Thank you, students.